Would the Honourable Minister please proceed with her statement?
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I rise today to commemorate December 6th, the National Day of Remembrance and Action on Violence Against Women. This day was established by the Parliament of Canada in 1991 to honour the lives of the 14 women murdered at L'École Polytechnique in Montreal in 1989. The Montreal Massacre, as it came to be known, was a watershed moment. It was clearly an anti-feminist attack, and it sparked a new dialogue within and beyond the women's equality-seeking public. How could such an atrocity take place? What actions could we take individually and collectively to ensure it never happened again? Yet here we are, 29 years later, and we continue in our struggle to address gender-based violence. More recent movements and initiatives such as Me Too, Been Raped, Never Reported, and the Unfounded Report, and the National Inquiry on Murdered and Missing Indigenous Women and Girls remind us that in Canada, we have work ahead of us. As difficult as it is to think about that tragic day, we need to pause and reflect. We must really think about the name of the day, the National Day of Remembrance and Action on Violence Against Women in Canada. Indeed, it calls upon us to remember, to pay tribute to the women who died that day, as well as the many women who continue to lose their lives to gender-based violence. In addition to honoring the lives lost, we must acknowledge the suffering of countless women and girls who continue to face abuse in their daily realities. We must recognize the toll gender-based violence is taking on all of us, women, men, children, neighborhoods, communities, and workplaces. Society as a whole is negatively impacted, and we cannot let this continue. The day calls for action. It lifts us up. It makes us realize that we can all take part in addressing the inequalities that are at the root of gender-based violence. It gives us purpose. Even the smallest actions at the individual level can bring meaningful change. We can speak out when we see acts of violence or harassment of any kind. We can teach our children to be kind and compassionate. We can help our youth understand what healthy relationships look like and how to reach out for help when they need it. We can support the individuals and organizations working to promote women's equality and address gender-based violence. And we can denounce misogyny. Many organizations will be holding memorial services and vigils throughout our province today. This evening, I invite all my colleagues to join me in a memorial service starting at 5 p.m. in the Rotunda. We will honor the memory of the 14 young women killed in the Montreal Massacre in 1989 and the women in Manitoba who died of acts of violence in 2018. I encourage all to attend and to reflect on ways that you can take concrete action to address this serious local, national, and global human rights issue. Madam Speaker, I would like to ask that following the statements made by my colleagues, that we observe a moment of silence to mourn the women we have lost. Thank you, Madam Speaker.